Okay, so this should be the last video. If you're so now what we want to do is we want to kind of cut through this with something that is 6 wide. So we just made what we thought was, or what we know is 6 wide. Excellent. And so what we want to do is we want to make this whole thing a group. We've already done all our measurements that we need, so we can triple click, make it a group. So that is a group in itself. Now what we want to do is we can use push-pull, take this, pull it up, just so I know that it's tall enough. Good. And we know that it's even because we lined it up. And then we're going to take this and go all the way through. So that's kind of piercing through. Now we want to triple click this and make that a group. So we have this group and this group. Now, hopefully from last class, if this works, we're going to take the subtract tool. We want to subtract this from this. Yeah, I was a little worried about this one. So this, it's not really showing that it's a group. So what we're going to have to do, that might be tough actually. So I'm actually going to bring everything back to before this was even a group. And what we want to find now are lines that we don't need that are here. That's how you get rid of them. Let's see if I can zoom into the shape because that might be where some of them are. I don't think that I can. So seems like we're having some difficulty. I know that we hid those. We hid those lines. We really want to make it. Oh, you know what? This is that's silly of me. I didn't even think about this. This is a lot easier than I thought. So instead of actually, I'm going to kind of take this part and ignore that because I kind of just made a silly mistake. We know that this is the midpoint. Just measure 3 here to the right. Go all the way up. It's got to be on the blue axis though, obviously. And then we can go 3 over here. Go all the way up on the blue axis. Now with this, we should just be able to push pull. Okay, so we didn't actually need to do all that fancy stuff. Let's see, I wonder what the problem is over there. Sure, we could just get rid of it like that. Excellent. So that's actually a lot easier than what I was trying to do before. That's just a hole going through there. Hopefully the back is still intact, the bottom, excellent. And now the last thing is this circle over here. Says that it's pretty much at the halfway point and has a diameter of 15, so that's a radius of 7.5. So you just go here, you pretty much find the center of this, and you make it 7.5, and you can use push-pull to kind of go through, you can make sure that it kind of cuts out at the other end, as you can see it does. You do the same thing on this end. So we found midpoint, midpoint. That should be of no difficulty to us now. Now we use push-pull. And I think I accidentally clicked it into place. So I'm going to make this again. Now, okay, good. I can probably just zoom in to see when it's gonna disappear. Good, now it's clearly going through now. So perfect. This is what you want. Just to throw a couple extra dimensions in there, we do wanna confirm that that's 6. Excellent. We can confirm that that has a diameter of 15. All those are important. So you don't even have to really, I'm gonna make it a group now just for the sake of painting it. Because if you make it a group and you right click and you go to entity info, you can make it whatever you want. So I'm going to make it light purple. Great. So that looks awesome. And then the last thing that you have to do, or you're going to get no credit, is you have to go and insert your name. Oh, that's not my name. So you insert your name, you place it down, and then you scale it up so that you can see it. So if I could do this, I have 8 seconds left. Scale it up so you can see the name and you take a screenshot.